Assalamu alaikum, 9 class. Today the lesson that we are going to study and discuss is the poem Stopping by Woods on a Snowy Evening. It is the 12th in your book. First of all, let's discuss something about the poet. The poem is written by the American poet Robert Frost. He was born in San Francisco, California on 26 March 1874. He died on 29 January 1963 in Boston following a cancer operation. Frost used in his poetry the language of everyday life and depicted scenes from the common man's experience and from country life. He received many honors for his poetry. Stopping by Woods is written by Robert Frost. He was a very good poet, and he was one of the most known American poet in the history of poetry. He was born in the state of America, which is San Francisco. It is a small town in California on 26th March 1874. He died on 29 January in 1963 after surviving a short time after his cancer operation. He died in Boston. In his poetry, he used his life experiences to show his life experiences, to depict his life experiences and the country and the way the people of the country live outside country. Country life means the people who lives a little far from the main country, so that there is no pollution on there or वहाँ शहर का इतना शोर नहीं होता. जैसे अगर मैं कराची की आपको एग्जांपल दूँ तो फॉर नया नाजमाबाद एंड बहरिया टाउन, दे आर फार फ्रॉम द मेन सिटी, सो वो कंट्री लाइफ कहलाती है वो, ठीक है. सो ही यूज टू शेयर हिज एक्सपीरियंसेस और हिज लाइफ टाइम एक्सपीरियंसेस इन थ्रू हिज पोम्स एंड he used to travel a lot in his life. So moved from places to places. So उनको कंट्री लाइफ के लोग किस तरह से वक्त गुजारते हैं, ज़िंदगी गुजारते हैं जो शहर से थोड़ा दूर रहते हैं, ही डिपिक्टेड देम देयर लाइफ इन हिज पोम्स. लेट्स स्टार्ट द पोम. हुज वुड्स दीज आर आई थिंक आई नो, हिज हाउस इन द विलेज थो, ही विल नॉट सी मी स्टॉपिंग हेयर टू वॉच हिज वुड्स वुड्स फिल अप विद स्नो. Once he was traveling from one place to another, and it was a winter night, it was falling, it was snow falling, and he was traveling, he stopped at the far edge of a forest, and it was one of the most beautiful views that he has seen in his life, that there is a vast dark forest. Because it was a winter night, it was a vast and a dark forest, and it was fulfilling with white snow. So just let your imagination run wild and think, if you are standing on a corner of a forest, on a wood, and it is falling, it and it is snowing, and it the woods are filling with snow, white cloudy snow, it is one of the most cherished moment anyone could see in his or her life. So standing at the edge of the forest, he was thinking that who is the owner of these woods. He thought that the owner of the woods was a man that he knew that lived in the nearby village, but he thought that he wouldn't know that I stopped here to watch his woods filled with snow. So he thought it doesn't matter that he knew or not, he just stood there and stopped to watch the woods filled with snow. My little horse must think it queer to stop without her farmhouse near, between the woods and frozen lake, the darkest evening of the year. He was talking to himself that his horse would think it queer. Queer means strange. His horse would think it strange that they are stopping at the edge of the woods where there is no farmhouse to spend the night in, or and it is snowing. Foremost, it is snowing, and it is the darkest evening of the winter. Like, जैसे winter में हम होते हैं ना, कि एक आपको पता है गर्मियों का एक दिन सबसे बड़ा होता है, और इसी तरह सर्दियों में एक दिन होता है जो सबसे छोटा होता है. तो that is darkest evening of the year. That is known as the darkest evening of the year. तो उस रात वो सोच रहे होंगे कि उनका घोड़ा सोच रहा होगा कि कितना स्ट्रेंज है यहाँ रुकना, वेयर देर इज़ नो फार्म हाउस नियर बाय. सो दैट सो he might thought that they are staying for the night and they're stopped near the wood, at the edge of the woods to see the woods, just to see the wood at the darkest evening of the year, and there was a frozen lake nearby. So his horse would think it's strange. He gives his harness bells a shake to ask if there is some mistake. The only other sounds the sweep of easy wind and downy flake. As if the horse shaked his harness bell. Harness bell is used to control the horse. It is, jaise hum naal bandi kehte hain jisko. It is a bell that is used to control the horse. And he shaked his head just as if to ask, as if to, कि जैसे वो पूछना चाह रहा है कि हम यहाँ क्यों रुके हैं, क्या कोई गलती हो गई, इफ देर इज़ सम मिस्टेक दैट वी आर स्टेइंग, दैट वी आर स्टॉपिंग हेयर, क्योंकि देर वॉज नो साउंड नियर बाय, सिर्फ जो आवाज़ें आ रही थी वो गिरती हुई स्नो की और चलती हुई हवा की आवाज़ें थी. देर वॉज नो साउंड एक्सेप्ट दीज दो साउंड, द फॉलिंग ऑफ द स्नो एंड द एयर स्वीपिंग हेयर एंड देयर. The woods are lovely, dark and deep, but I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep and miles to go before I sleep. And then the rider, Robert Frost, thought that the woods were lovely, the woods were beautiful at that time of the night, but they were dark and they were deep, like bahut gehri thi aur bahut zyada ghani thi. So, but he had to be somewhere because he had to reach his destination. He had to go miles before resting. Matlab usko bahut aage ka safar tay karna tha. So it was not appropriate to stand and watch the woods fulfill up with snow as long as he wanted to, because he had a destination in his mind that he has to reach by the end of the time, by the end of the day, or by the time he would stop for resting night out. So he just stood there for a few minutes, watched the snow fulfill the woods to his heart's content, and then he left to fulfill his journey.